Rotating families in Revit around a horizontal plane is really easy. However, if you want to rotate them on any other plane, well, it's going to be extremely complicated and usually Revit is just not going to allow that. In this video, I'm going to be showing you a workaround that's going to allow you to rotate or basically orbit your families in any direction you want so you can get some really unique positionings for your families in Revit. And best of all, it's really easy and quick. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and this is the project that I'm going to be using. So here we have an example where we have this display for furniture, in this case for chairs, and we want them to be tilted a little bit. However, we obviously cannot tilt these families, so we have to adapt them to become able to be rotated or orbited in all directions. Now, by the way, this workflow has been inspired by NGpedia YouTube channel, so props to them for figuring this out. So anyways, how do we do this? Well, the first step is to go here to File, and then go to New, and then start a new family. For this family, it's really important to pick out the proper template. I'm just going to go back one step and pick out English metric. And then here you want to search for generic models and you want to pick out adaptive. Adaptive is going to give you the most flexibility. Then I'm just going to hit open, and that's going to open up this adaptive family interface. And here you want to go to the draw panel and pick out the point element. This point element can be placed anywhere, just like this. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and then you want to select it and you want to convert it into an adaptive point, just like this. Now we like to center it, so I'm just going to open up the reference level and see. Okay, so it's off to the side a little bit, so let's just use the align tool. AL is the shortcut, just to align this properly, just like that. And then I can even open up the front elevation and just make sure that this is aligned to the level as well. Okay, there we go, perfect. Hit the escape key a couple of times. So now once we have this point in place, this is going to work as our kind of tool for rotation. Now it's time to bring in the actual family geometry so we can get that from the project here. So for example, in this case, let's say I want to work with this. I can just pick this out, go to edit family, and then here I can go to load into project. I can even go to load into project and close, which is perfect. And let's pick out this family one, click OK. And do you want to save changes? Nope. And there we go. So now this is loaded into this project and I can just pick this out and just place it like that. So I want to place it with one of these legs over that point. If I go to the 3D view, let's just see how this is placed. Yeah, perfect. I like the way that this turned out. You can align it even further if you want. I'm just going to keep it like this. I prefer this approach. And then before we move forward and we actually save and load this family, important step is to pick out the correct category. So here, as you can see, this is a generic model. However, this is obviously furniture. So let's just go here to family categories and parameters and search for furniture and just pick that out. So you just want to have this available, click OK. And now as you can see, it says furniture as a category. Then you want to save it. So I'm just going to save it on desktop as our rotatable chair. Click save. And now we can load this into the project. So let's just go here, load into project, and it's here. Now it's going to give you an option to place it on face or work plane. And this basically means that when you come and choose any face, it's going to place that chair there. So we can just place them like this next to each other. And I'm just going to now hit the escape key a couple of times. Now, in order to make further changes and just further rotate this chair. So for example, let's say I want this chair to be kind of falling over on the other chair. We can actually do that. So what I can do for this one, for example, is I can first pick out the plane on which we want to apply the rotation. So for example, in this case, let's say I want to just rotate it around. I would simply go here to the architecture tab and then go to the work plane and click on set work plane, and I can just go with pick a plane and pick this face here, just like that. And now when I select the chair and go into rotate, it basically rotates around that point in this particular plane. So I just want to rotate it like this. I can move it a little bit, just like that. Perfect. Next, I want to make it look like it's falling over. So for that, what I can do is I can go again back to architecture, set work plane, and yeah, let's go with pick a plane. Okay, and now let's pick this plane. So this face here, just like that. And now when I select this and go to rotate, as you can see, it's going to rotate like this. So now I can rotate it like that, like it's falling over. Yeah, looks fun. Okay, and then we should be able to move it. Let's see. Okay, so let's hit the escape key a couple of times. Let's then again go to set work plane, pick a plane, and then let's pick this plane. And now let's try to move it off to the side like that. Okay, kind of escaped us a little bit. So it can be a little bit tricky to navigate with these, but you can try to use the arrow keys in order to reposition it a little bit. So I think we're getting there. Let's see. Okay, so it's moving this way. It's kind of going down a little bit. Yeah, I think this could work. And then perhaps we can bring this one closer in like that. And yeah, it looks like it's falling over. So there we go. So by using this method and using the adaptive point to create this family, now you can basically rotate these around or like orbit them in any direction that you want. So this is going to give you much flexibility. So however you want to position these items, this is really good for things like books or pillows, for interior design, where you just want it to kind of look like it's just kind of fallen over and it's going to look really natural in the renderings. This is the best approach for doing something like that. Now, if you want to get access to this Revit project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.